Give me a second here now. Alright, we're going to need some of this sound circuitry. We need to make sure we keep the device under a certain decibel range so we don't upset upset people upstairs and or get evicted. Don't want to get evicted, right? But kind of hope the time device is going to work properly. Haven't decided on a name yet as I'm working. Alright, so this is a little bit of work. If I did my math right, this should work properly. So this is what we're gonna do. One sec. Let's see. Conductors. Ah, that's the ones we need there. Those guys. So let's get these off. Be right back. She's going. So, I'm going to take this guy off here. Heat up the side of the arm. Yep. There's one off. And there we go. That's an important piece. Also, we need the other one. There we go, we got two of them. Now we need to attach those. We still gotta use their circuit board, just because we took those off and just doing a temporary bypass of the compensator on this one. This should do the job. Reversing time isn't that hard to do, I don't think. So, let's where does he go? Oh, there's the R230. Okay, I know where I'm to now. Where are you to? Okay, so I'll put you, you got a little holder for me, I think. Let's see if it'll go over there. Not going in mood. So he's going to go right there once he gets in. And you are in. Now I need some solder. Sorry for the distraction, people. I got a girlfriend who just doesn't understand the complexities of a building time reversal device. I've got a bit of solder, it needs a bit of flux though. Give this to stick. Okay, totally. Oh yeah. There. I think I got a good connection made. Now. Fast forward a little bit here.